initially, I wasn't interested in the character or the script because it was so violent and it was so misogynistic. But Josh came on to the movie and he got Jimmy into the movie, and Jimmy started doing some rewrites on it immediately with the character. And really just the opportunity to work with Josh is what propelled me to be in this. I mean, I'm lucky to be in this.
I mean, she was really great, you know? She put herself out there. I remember the read-through that we did. It's very important for me to have a read-through. And then you kind of get the nerves out of the way and people who, you know, get the, you know, you start to get some of the bad acting out of the way. And that's the place to do it. And to create a place that, to create a setting of safety, you know? And Megan, I got nervous. And I wouldn't even look at her because she put herself out there, I think more than anybody at the table, more than Malkovich, more than Fassbender, more than any of these people. And really put herself out there, establishing the fact that I'm willing to do anything to find this character and be good in this movie. And I think she's very good. I think she's as good as she can be at this moment. Mm-hmm. I don't think that she could have done any better at this moment. And I love that when I see somebody who's 22 years old is wide open and vulnerable, allows themselves to be vulnerable enough to learn and to be affected. And she was very emotionally available, you know, as opposed to all this stuff that I had read about her and this stuff that I continued to read about her, you know, blips here and there. I don't see the connection.
Do you need time with him?
Around all these toothless prostitutes and all this ugliness or cosmetic ugliness, not really ugliness, but cosmetic ugliness, and seeing Megan, this almost alien beauty, and her being the most damaged of anybody. And him obviously being damaged cosmetically and, you know, tortured, you know, emotionally tortured.